So today on MapBreak Studio, I thought I'd do something a little different and bring on a guest artist. Her name is Jen Jaeger, and I came across her at the Final Cut Pro Global Summit last November. We were both teaching sessions there, and I thought what she was doing was great, and I thought, why not have her on the show and have her do her own tutorial about motion? So here she is to tell a little bit about herself and check out her tutorial.
Hey, Mark, thank you so much for having me today. I'm really excited to be here with you and talk about my favorite program, Apple Motion, which I've been using for a lot of years now, ever since I've been editing on Final Cut, maybe 10, 15 years. And I've really just grown with Apple Motion and grown to love it so much so that I actually have my own YouTube channel just dedicated to Final Cut and Apple Motion tutorials, which you can find under Jen Jaeger Pro Tutorials if you guys are curious about that. But I'm really excited to show you how to make a looping background using the sequence replicator behavior in Apple Motion. Okay, here we are in Apple Motion. I'm working in a 4K project today, and my project duration is 15 seconds long. The first thing I'm going to do is head on over to Generators. We're going to find the gradient and drop that here into my project pane. And let me just change these colors to the color scheme that we're going to be working on today. The next thing I'm going to do is head on over to Library. We're going to look for Shapes, and we're going to select this triangle and drop it into our project pane on top of my gradient. We're going to change the color of this triangle to a green that's just a little bit darker than the green in my gradient. The next thing I'm going to do is head on over to the Shape Tools here in the center of my screen, and I'm going to select the Line option. And I'm going to draw a straight line down through the center of my triangle. I'm going to hold down the Shift key on my keyboard as I do this to make sure that my line is perfectly vertical. And I'm going to head on over to Properties and reset my parameters to make sure that my line is perfectly centered. Now let's head on over to Shape in that inspector window and make this line a pink that's slightly darker than the pink in our gradient. And let's change the start and end caps to square. And let's reduce the width to 15. The next thing I want to do is change the anchor point of this line. So I can do that by heading on over to the Tools menu down here at the bottom left of my canvas, or I can just right click in the canvas and select anchor point. And now I'm going to use this green arrow here to raise my anchor point on the Y axis. So when we rotate this line, it doesn't rotate right from dead center. It's going to rotate more toward the top. Okay, so those are all the elements we need to make. Now let's select this line in our project pane, head on up to the top right of the screen and hit this replicator button. And now you can see we have many different versions of that line. And if you look at my project pane, I have this replicator here. And then if we look at the inspector window, we have a replicator tab with a lot of adjustments that we can make. The default is a rectangle shape and the arrangement is a tile fill, which is what we're going to be working on today. But if you haven't played with the replicator, I definitely recommend hitting this drop down and checking out all the different shapes and arrangements that you can do with motion. Let's look at that size value. We are at 300 by default, but if we drop down on size, I can increase the width and height individually. I want to increase the width so it's wider than my canvas. And let's do the same for the height. And now let's play with the number of columns and rows. The default is 5. If I raise this slider, you can see I get more versions of my lines. Let's set this one to 10 and let's leave the rows the same. Now what I want to do is rotate these lines so that they're more on a diagonal. What I'm going to do today is look here in my project pane. Underneath the replicator, I have this line with this circle next to it. And the original line that I drew is actually turned off. So if we select the line under the replicator and look here in our inspector, I'm going to change the angle on this to 30. And now you can see the lines are disconnected, whereas before they were connected. Let's fix this by heading over to our project pane, selecting replicator again. And let's look at this setting here called tile offset. By changing the tile offset, I can get those lines to connect again, which is what I want. And I want to make sure they're overlapping slightly for this particular design. All right, the next thing I want to do is get another set of lines just like this, but going in the opposite direction. So what I'm going to do is select this replicator in my project pane. I'm going to right click and I'm going to hit duplicate. So I have another copy of that replicator. Now let's head on over to filters, distortion, and select flop. Now we've reversed that second replicator. So I have this diamond pattern. Just to stay organized, I'm going to rename these objects in my project pane so we can keep track of what we're doing. Let me extend this out a little bit so you can see. Okay, now I'm going to go back to replicator line one and I'm going to duplicate it again and drag up that copy all the way to the top of our group. So now we've got a third duplicate of our replicator, but I want to replace the lines with the green triangle that we created at the start of this project. The first thing I'm going to do is just rename this replicator again, replicator triangle, so we can keep track of things. And down below this replicator, you can see we've got this line copy one. If I select this, you can see in my object source, there is that pink line. But watch what happens here if I grab that green triangle and drop it into that box. We've replaced the pink line with the green triangle. Now I want to turn off that original green triangle. Watch what happens in my canvas, it disappears. And let's rename that object source just so we stay organized. Back on the replicator triangle, let's increase the number of columns to 11 and increase the number of rows to 7. And then let's select the object source of our green triangle in that replicator and reduce the scale. And let's change the rotation of these ones to 60. Now let's go back to the replicator triangle level and let's change the tile offset here. What I'm looking for is for at least one of the rows of these triangles to align with one of the diagonal lines that's going from top to bottom in our screen. So we know we're working at the right angles here. All right, so the next thing we need to do is try to reposition these triangles so they are centered in our diamonds. And I can see they need to be spaced out a little bit more, so let's head back to our replicator on the size value and increase the width. So you can see we're not increasing the number of columns that we have, we're just spacing them out more. So you can just keep playing with that value to make sure that you get your elements aligned in the way that you want. So now we've created all of our elements, now we need to animate them and have some fun. The first thing I'm going to do is select Replicator Line 1. Let's head on up to Behaviors at the top center of the screen. Let's head down to Replicator, and then there's only one behavior in there called the Sequence Replicator. Let's select that. Now here under Behaviors in our Inspector window, you can see the Sequence Replicator, and we can add parameters to the animation of this line. So for this particular replicator, I'm going to hit this drop-down for Add, and we're going to add a rotation. We're going to add an opacity, and we're going to add a position. And now let's adjust these values. On the rotation, I'm going to set it to a full 360. On the opacity, let's bring it down to about 25. On the position, we're just going to adjust the Y value, and we're going to bring that to a positive 200. All right, now let's look below here under sequence control. Under sequencing, we're going to go from to to through. We're going to leave the unit size set on object. We're going to change the spread to 20. On traversal, we're going to change this to accelerate. And for loops, I told you that this project is 15 seconds long. Let's set this one to 4, so it's going to loop 4 times over 15 seconds. All right, let's look at what we have. I'll run my playhead down the timeline. You can see the action originates from the center. Let's change that. Let's make sure we're on the replicator in our project pane. Now let's hit the replicator tab in our inspector window and draw our attention to this line here, origin. We're going to change it from center, which is the default, to lower left. So now let me run my playhead again in my timeline so you can see the action now originates from the bottom left of the screen. Now let's head down to our timeline, find that sequence replicator behavior. Let's copy it and paste it to our replicator line 2. But because we flopped that replicator line 2, some of our actions are going to be backwards, so we're going to have to make some adjustments here. Back in the Behaviors tab, let's change the rotation from 360 to negative 360. And then on the Replicator tab, instead of originating from the lower left, we're actually going to set it to lower right. Because everything's backwards now because of that flop filter. And now it all matches coming from the lower left. Now let's draw attention to those green triangles. Let's select them in the project pane, head on over to Behaviors, go down to Replicator, Sequence Replicator, and on these parameters, we're going to go Rotation, Color, and Scale. Let's set the rotation to 45. For the color, let's pick a sort of darker teal color. And on the scale, we're going to dial it all the way down to 0. Now on the sequencing, we're going to change it from 2 to through. We're going to leave unit size on object. We're going to change the spread to 20. For traversal, we're going to go to accelerate. And for loops, again, we're going to do 4. And again, let's head on over to the replicator tab and go from center on the origin to lower left. And here's our action. It looks great, but I do want to make some other adjustments because this is a background, so I want to soften things up a little bit. So on the replicator triangle, let's head on over to filters and we're going to go to blur, Gaussian blur, and we're going to crank that up to say 91. Now for both of the lines replicators, let's just dial down the opacity so they're not quite so bright. And let's play it back.
Thanks, Jen. That was really great. I love working with replicators. Hope you guys enjoyed this. Please leave us a comment below. We'll see you next time here on MacBreak Studio.